Good morning, everybody. This is Suma from Department of Mathematics. Today, we shall discuss about the topic matrix. To begin with, the application of matrices. Matrices in daily life is used to represent the real world data such as population of people, infant mortality rate. It is also used in statistics, linear programming subjects, applied mathematics such as classical mechanics, optics, quantum mechanics to know the motion of rigid bodies. Let me tell you all about the definition of matrices. Before we start off with the definition of matrices, let me tell you the weightage of this chapter prescribed by the PUE board. The weightage of this chapter is for 9 marks, wherein one question will be asked for 1 mark, one question will be asked for 3 marks, and one question will be asked in 5 marks. Part A contains one question which carries 1 mark. Part C carries one question which is for 3 marks. And part D contains one question which is for 5 marks. So totally this chapter has a weightage of 9 marks. Then moving back to the definition of matrices. What is the definition of matrix? An arrangement of numbers. When we say arrangement of numbers, it may be an array of numbers arranged in the form of rows and columns is known as matrix. I'll repeat that. An arrangement of numbers may be a real number or a complex number arranged in the form of rows and columns enclosed within the brackets. When I say brackets, it may be a braces or it may be a flower brackets or it may be a square brackets. I repeat that. An arrangement of numbers may be a real number or a complex number arranged in the form of rows and columns enclosed within the pair of brackets is known as matrix. When I say rows and columns, what is a row? The horizontal line of numbers. The horizontal line of numbers is known as rows. The vertical lines of numbers is known as columns. Matrices are denoted by capital letters A, B, C, etc., etc., up to Z. To summarize, it is an arrangement of numbers, maybe a real number or a complex number, arranged in the form of rows and columns, enclosed within the brackets, pair of brackets, maybe braces, flower brackets or square brackets is known as a matrix. It is denoted by capital letters A, B, C, etc., etc., up to Z. The second definition of matrix. What do you mean by order of a matrix? What is order of a matrix? It represents the number of rows and number of columns present in the given matrix. I repeat that. What is order of a matrix? It represents the number of rows. When I say row, the horizontal lines of numbers, and the number of columns. When I say columns, the vertical lines of numbers. It represents the number of rows and number of columns present in the given matrix. Say for example, A is a matrix containing the elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. What are rows? The horizontal lines of numbers. So this is considered to be the first row and this is considered to be the second row. How many columns? This is the first column, this is the second column and this is the third column. So what do you mean by order of a matrix? It represents the number of rows and number of columns in the given matrix. We specifically write the order of this matrix A as 2 rows cross 3 columns. This matrix A contains two rows, that is the number 2 cross, it is read as 2 cross 3 or 2 by 3 with 3 columns. The first column contains an elements 1, 4, the second column contains an element 2, 5 and the third column contains an elements 3, 6. So what is order of a matrix? It represents the number of rows and number of columns present in the given matrix. In general, suppose a matrix A has m rows and matrix B has n columns. In that case, we generally denote the order of a matrix as m cross n. It is read as m cross n or it is read as m by n. Now, the elements present in the numbers present inside the matrix is known as elements of the matrix. The numbers present inside the matrix is known as elements of the matrix. And these elements are generally denoted by small letters, say A. I shall explain this with an example. Say for example, a matrix A contains 4 elements. What will be the order of this matrix? It contains 2 rows cross. How many columns does it contain? 2 columns. So it is 2 cross 2. The numbers present inside this matrix is known as elements of the matrix. When I say element, 1 is an element, 2 is an element, 3 is an element of the matrix A, 4 is also the element of matrix A. And this element 1 is denoted by small letter A given by A11. What does it mean? A is element in the first row, first column. 1 is in the first row, 1 is also in the first column. So the element A belongs to first row, first column. So what would be the element 2 now? We shall write it as A12. A is an element, that element is nothing but 2. 1 represents the row, 2 represents the column. The first digit represents the row, the second digit represents the column. Similarly, the first digit represents the row, the second digit represents the column. When I speak about A11, this is the first element which belongs to first row, first column. This is first row, this is the first row. Which column does it belong to? This is the first column and this is the second column. So 2 belongs to first row and second column. So in general it is written by A12. Similarly, how do we denote the third element? A21. That is second row, first column. 3 is an element which is in the second row and first column. Similarly, 4 is an element which belongs to which row? Second row. This is the first row and this is the second row. Which column does it belong to? This is the first column and this is the second column. So 4 is an element which belongs to second row and second column. Let me explain you about these elements by taking more examples. Consider a matrix A containing the elements 1, 2, 3, 7, 8 and 9. What is the order of this matrix? Rows into columns. How many rows does this matrix A contain? This will be the first row and this is the second row. Which is the first row? 1, 2 and 3 represents the first row. 7, 8 and 9 represents the second row. So totally how many rows does this matrix contains? 2 rows cross. How many columns does it contain? It contains 3 columns. The first column is 1 and 7. The second column is 2 and 8. And the third column is 3 and 9. So the order of this matrix is 2 cross 3, which means the matrix A contains 2 rows and 3 columns. Now, the numbers present inside the matrix is known as elements of the matrix. The numbers present inside the matrix is known as elements of the matrix. These elements are denoted by small letter A. These elements are denoted by small letter A. How do we read these elements which is inside the matrix? We denote the number 1 as element A11, which means A is an element and that element is 1. 1, the first number stands for first row and the second number stands for first column. A11, which means 1 is an element which is in the first row and in the first column. Similarly, what would be the element in the second row? How do we represent this? We represent this as 1, 2, and read as A12. A is an element. Which element are we speaking about? The element 2. What does 1 represent? It represents, it is in the first row. What does 2 represent? It represents, it is in the second column. Now, can we see 2 in the first row? It is in the first row. Can we say that 2 is in the second column? Yes, because this is the first column and this will be the second column. So A is an element which is 2, which is in the first row and second column. Similarly, how do we represent the number 3? A13. What does it mean? A is an element which is nothing but 3. 1, which means the element belongs to the first row. Can we see 3 belonging in the first row? Yes. And what does this 3 represent? It represents the third column. So in generally, we denote it as A13, which means the element A belongs to first row and third column. Now, coming back to the second row, elements are denoted by small letter A. A is an element containing 7. How do we represent this? 2, 1. What does this 2 mean? The first digit always represents the row. The second digit always represents the column. The number 7 is in second row. I'm speaking about horizontal line. And first column, that is the vertical line. 7 is an element which is in the second row, first column. Similarly, 8 is an element in which row and which column? Which row is in 8? 8 is in the second row. This is the first row and this is the second row. In which column it is? This is the first column and this will be the second column. So this will be A22. 8 is an element which belongs to second row and second column. Similarly, 9 is an element which belongs to second row and third column. When I say second row and third column, 9 is an element which is in the second row and 9 is an element which is in the third column. This is the first column, this is the second column and this is the third column. So we represent the numbers which is in the matrix A is called elements of the matrix and we denote them by rows and columns in this method. Speaking about the next topic, we shall speak about types of matrices. First one, we shall speak about zero matrix or null matrix. Zero matrix or null matrix. As the name itself mentions, the elements inside the matrix must be equal to zero. Only those type of matrices are known as null matrix or zero matrix. A matrix in which all the elements are equal to zero is known as a zero matrix or a null matrix, which is denoted by capital O. Say for example, O is a matrix which contains the elements 0. As the name itself mentions, it's a zero matrix. A matrix in which all the elements are zero is known as a zero matrix. It is denoted by capital O. So what will be the order of this matrix now? As I told you earlier, rows into columns represents the order of a matrix. How many rows does it contain? It contains 2 rows. This will be the first row and this will be the second row. How many columns does it contain? 2 columns. So what will be the order of this matrix? order of this null matrix O is given by 2 cross 2. This is the definition of zero matrix or null matrix. Second definition, we shall speak about row matrix. Row matrix. A matrix which contains only one row is known as a row matrix. I repeat that, a matrix which contains only one row is known as a row matrix. Say for example, M is equal to 1, 2 and 3. Matrices are denoted by capital letters. It may be any letter from A to Z. How many rows does it contain? The sleeping line or the horizontal line is known as rows. How many horizontal lines are there? There are only one horizontal line, so the order of this matrix will be 1 cross. How many columns it contains? This will be the first column, this will be the second column, and this will be the third column. So it contains 3 columns. So row matrix is a matrix which contains only one row, is known as a row matrix. And this is the example of a row matrix. Coming back to the next definition, column matrix. What is a column matrix? A matrix containing only one column is known as a column matrix. Say for example, matrix M contains an elements 1, 2 and 3. How many rows does this matrix have? This is the first row, this is the second row and this is the third row. So it is 3 cross. How many columns does it contain? The vertical lines of numbers is known as column. There is only one vertical line and therefore the column matrix column will be 1. It is read, the order of this matrix is read as 3 cross 1, which means it has 3 rows and 1 column. A row matrix is a matrix which contains only one row. Column matrix is a matrix which contains only one column. I repeat that. Before we move on to the next definition, let me quickly summarize the three types of matrices. Zero matrix or null matrix. Zero matrix or a null matrix is a matrix in which all the elements are zero, denoted by capital letter O. Second definition, row matrix. A matrix which contains only one row is known as a row matrix. Here we can see only one row with 3 columns. It may not be with 3 columns. It may be any number of columns provided it has to be only one row. Moving back to the third definition, column matrix. It is a matrix in which it contains only one column. How many rows does it contain? 3 rows. How many columns does it contain? 1 column. Moving on to the fourth definition, fourth type of matrices. Fourth type of matrices will be a square matrix. What is a square matrix? A matrix in which the number of rows must be equal to number of columns is known as a square matrix. I repeat that, a matrix in which number of rows must be equal to number of columns. These type of matrices is known as square matrix. What is a square matrix? A matrix in which number of rows is equal to number of columns. These type of matrices is known as a square matrix. When I say equal to, their orders must be same. When I say orders, rows and columns must have the same number of elements. Say for example, matrix X contains an element 2, 3, 4, 5. What is the order of this matrix? It is 2 cross 2, which means it has 2 rows and 2 columns. Similarly, I shall give you one more example. What is the order of this matrix T? How many rows does it contain? 3 rows. First row, second row and third row. That is 3 cross. How many columns does it contain? 3 columns. First, second and third. So a square matrix is a matrix in which number of rows must be equal to number of columns. In a square matrix, the elements from the left top corner to the right bottom corner is known as principal diagonal elements. In a square matrix, the elements from the left top corner, this is the left top corner, to the right bottom corner, that is from the element 1 to the last element 9, these elements are known as principal diagonal elements. In a square matrix, the elements from the left top corner to the right bottom corner is known as principal diagonal elements. We can explain about this principal diagonal elements in a 2 cross 2 matrix as well. So when we consider a 2 cross 2 square matrix, which are the principal diagonal elements here? As I mentioned you earlier, the elements from the left top corner to the right bottom corner are known as principal diagonal elements. So in this matrix S, the principal diagonal elements are 2 and 5. That is about the square matrix. Speaking rectangular matrix. What is a rectangular matrix? What is a rectangular matrix? A matrix in which number of rows not equal to number of columns is known as a rectangular matrix. I repeat that, a matrix in which number of rows not equal to number of columns is known as a rectangular matrix. In a square matrix, rows must be equal to columns. In a rectangular matrix, rows must not be equal to number of columns. So, what is a rectangular matrix? A matrix in which the number of rows is not equal to number of columns is known as a rectangular matrix. Say for example, matrix S contains an element 2, 3, 4, 1, 2 and 3. What is the order of this matrix? It is rows into columns. How many rows does it contain? 2 rows. How many columns does it contain? 3 columns. So what will be the order of this matrix X? It is read as 2 cross 3. The matrix S contains 2 rows and 3 columns. These type of matrices are known as rectangular matrices. What is a rectangular matrix? A matrix in which the number of rows is not equal to number of columns is known as a rectangular matrix. What is a square matrix? It is a matrix in which the number of rows must be equal to number of columns. Moving on to the next type of matrices, that is diagonal matrix. Moving on to the diagonal matrices, it is a square matrix in which all the elements except the principal diagonal elements are 0. Diagonal matrix, it is a square matrix. When I say square matrix, rows must be equal to columns. So diagonal matrix is a square matrix in which all the elements except the principal diagonal elements are 0. Say for example, matrix A, which are the it is a square matrix. When I say diagonal matrix is also a square matrix, orders are same. When I say orders are same, row must be equal to columns. Say for example, the matrix A contains 3 cross 3 elements, that is 3 rows and 3 columns. So for better understanding, I would explain you all with these elements. 3 rows, 3 columns. First, second and third row, first, second and third column. This is the first row, second row and third row. This will be the first column, the second column and the third column. A diagonal matrix is a square matrix in which, except the principal diagonal elements, all the elements are zero. When I say principal diagonal elements, the elements from the left top corner to the right bottom corner, that is, say for example, 1, 2 and 3. Except the principal diagonal elements, rest all the elements are zero. And these type of matrices are known as diagonal matrix. These type of matrices are known as diagonal matrix. What is a diagonal matrix? It is a square matrix. When I say square matrix, orders must be same. It is a square matrix in which all the elements except the principal diagonal elements are zero. These are the principal diagonal elements. Except the principal diagonal elements, rest all the elements are zero. These type of matrices are known as diagonal matrix. Moving on to the next type of matrices, that is scalar matrix. Scalar matrix. What is a scalar matrix? A scalar matrix is a diagonal matrix. When I say diagonal matrix, the matrix except the principal diagonal elements are zero. Similarly, a scalar matrix is a diagonal matrix in which the principal diagonal elements are same except one. A scalar matrix is a diagonal matrix in which the principal diagonal elements must be same other than the digit 1. Example, scalar matrix is a diagonal matrix. When I say diagonal matrix, orders, it is nothing but a square matrix. Orders must be same. Say 3 cross 3. I would explain with the same example. Can I say this as a diagonal matrix? Because the elements above the principal diagonal and below the principal diagonal are zero. A scalar matrix is a diagonal matrix in which the principal diagonal elements must be same other than one. Okay? So mark this important. It is other than element one. Other than element one. That is about the scalar matrix. The next type of matrices is unit matrix or identity matrix. It is a diagonal matrix in which all the diagonal elements are equal to unity. It is a diagonal matrix in which all the diagonal elements are equal to unity. These type of matrices are known as unit matrix or identity matrix. It is a diagonal matrix in which all the diagonal elements are equal to unity. These type of matrices are known as unit matrix or identity matrix, which is denoted by capital I. It has to be denoted by capital I. Say for example, when you consider a 3 cross 3 matrix, as the definition state, it has to be a diagonal matrix in which the diagonal elements are equal to unity. When I say diagonal elements are equal to unity, the diagonal elements must be equal to 1. These are the diagonal elements, and these diagonal elements must be equal to 1. The rest, all the elements are zeros. This is nothing but unit matrices or identity matrix. Speaking on to the next type of matrices, that is upper triangular matrix. What is an upper triangular matrix, or when do we say it is a matrix is an upper triangular matrix? A square matrix is said to be upper triangular matrix if the elements below the principal diagonal are zero. When do we say a square matrix is upper triangular matrix, or what is the definition of upper triangular matrix? A square matrix is said to be an upper triangular matrix if the elements below the principal diagonal are zero. Say for example, it is a matrix S containing the elements. It has three rows and three columns. For a better understanding, it has to contain nine elements. 3 × 3 with which is nothing but 9 elements. A square matrix. When I say square matrix, order of the matrix must be same. That is, rows and columns must be same. A square matrix is said to be an upper triangular matrix if the elements below the principal diagonal are zero. These are the principal diagonal elements. So below the principal diagonal elements, the elements must be zero. These type of matrices are known as upper triangular matrices. Only these elements are zero. A square matrix is said to be an upper triangular matrix if the elements below the principal diagonal, are zero. These type of matrices are known as upper triangular matrices. Next, to speaking about lower triangular matrices. What is a lower triangular matrix? A square matrix is said to be lower triangular matrix if the elements above the principal diagonal are zero. A square matrix is said to be lower triangular matrix if the elements above the principal diagonal are zero. A square matrix is said to be lower triangular matrix. As the sentence itself mentions, a square matrix, rows must be equal to columns. So, say for example, a matrix C contains 9 elements in which there are 3 rows and 3 columns. There are 3 rows and 3 columns. Which are the principal diagonal elements here? The elements from the left top corner to the right bottom corner are known as principal diagonal elements. Let me explain this example comparing with the upper triangular matrix. What is a lower triangular matrix? A square matrix is said to be a lower triangular matrix if the elements above the principal diagonal must be zero. These are the principal diagonal elements. These elements must be zero. Then, these type of matrices are known as lower triangular matrices. With this, we finished the different types of matrices. Now, let me summarize the types of matrices we studied today. The first one is zero matrix or null matrix. The main key point here is it has to be denoted by zero. The elements inside the, all the elements inside this matrix must be zero. Row matrix. What is a row matrix? A matrix containing only one row is known as a row matrix and can be denoted by any alphabetical order in capital letters from A to Z. Column matrix. A matrix containing only one column is known as a column matrix. The next type of matrix which we discussed was a square matrix. A matrix which contains equal number of rows and equal number of columns. These type of matrices are known as square matrix. More importantly, in a square matrix, the elements from the left top corner to the right bottom corner, these type of elements are known as principal diagonal elements. Number of rows must be equal to number of columns. This is a square matrix. What is a rectangular matrix? It is a matrix in which number of rows is not equal to number of columns. And these type of matrices are known as rectangular matrix. Speaking about diagonal matrix. What is a diagonal matrix? It is once again a square matrix in which all the elements except the principal diagonal elements are zero. Scalar matrix. Scalar matrix is a diagonal matrix in which all the principal diagonal elements must be same other than one. Unit matrix or identity matrix. Here it has to be denoted by unit matrix or identity matrix has to be denoted by capital I. It is a diagonal matrix in which the diagonal elements are equal to unity, or it has to be equal to one only. These type of matrices are known as unit matrix or identity matrix. Moving on to the upper triangular matrix. What is upper triangular, or when do we say it is an upper triangular matrix? A square matrix in which the elements below the principal diagonal, can we see here the principal diagonal elements below this? The elements below the principal diagonal elements must be equal to zero. These type of matrices are known as upper triangular matrix. What is a lower triangular matrix? A square matrix is said to be a lower triangular matrix if the elements above the principal diagonal are zero. Above the principal diagonal are zero. These type of matrices are known as lower triangular matrices. With this, we completed the types of matrices. We shall go on for the assignment part, so that for your better understanding between both of us, we can, before we pass on to the next topic, you'll quickly try to solve these assignments. The first question is, define matrix. Second question, mention the different types of matrices. The third question will be, give an example for each type of matrices. Since you will mention the different types of matrices, see that you will give an example for each type of matrices. The next question will be, define principal diagonal elements by giving an example. You can define one matrix. If in that matrix, you can just tell us what is a principal diagonal elements. Moving on to the next topic of this matrix chapter, we shall speak about operation on matrices, which is also known as algebra of matrices. We shall speak about operation on matrices, or which is also known as algebra of matrices. The first one will be equality of matrices. The second one operation will be addition of matrices. The third operation will be subtraction of matrices. The fourth operation will be scalar multiplication. The fifth operation will be matrix multiplication. And the last one we will discuss about negative of a matrix. So to begin with, the first one, equality of matrices. As the name itself mentions, two matrices are said to be equal if and only if the order of both the matrices must be same, provided their corresponding elements are equal. I repeat that, equality of matrices. Two matrices are said to be equal if and only if the order of both the matrices must be same, then their corresponding elements are equal. Let me explain you all by giving an example. First one will be equality of matrices. Equality of matrices. Here, two matrices are said to be equal if and only if order of both the matrices must be same. Only then their corresponding elements are equal. Say for example, consider two matrix, the first matrix A and the second matrix B. Order of both the matrices must be same. If we consider here 2 cross 2 matrix, we can also consider matrix B to be of order 2 cross 2. Matrix A contains 1, 2, 3 and 4. The elements 1, 2, 3 and 4. The matrix B contains elements A, B, C, D. According to the definition of equality of matrices, two matrices are said to be equal only if order of both the matrices must be same, provided their corresponding elements are equal. Equality. When do we say if A is equal to B, that is if matrix A is equal to matrix B, then what is the corresponding element of 1 in the first matrix is equal to corresponding element of the second matrix, then what is equal to what? The element A must be equal to 1. Similarly, what is element B equal to? 2. What is element C equal to? 3. And what is element D equal to? Element D is equal to 4. This is known as equality of matrices. I repeat that two matrices, say A and B, are said to be equal if and only if order of both the matrices must be same, then their corresponding elements are equal. I explained you by giving an example. Matrix A contains four elements, that is 1, 2, 3 and 4. Order of this matrix is 2 cross 2. Matrix B contains four elements. Order of this matrix is 2 cross 2. The first condition of equality of matrices is satisfied, that is order of both the matrices are same. Then when do we say the corresponding elements are equal? When orders are same. What is A equal to? 1. What is B equal to? What is B equal to? 2. What is C equal to? 3. What is D equal to? 4. This is known as equality of matrices. Moving on to the second operation of matrices. What is the second operation of matrices? Addition of matrices. Addition of matrices. Two matrices, say A and B, can be added if and only if their orders are same, then the corresponding elements can be added. In case if you have any queries in today's session, feel free to upload your queries in the prescribed link. With this, I complete today's session. Thank you very much for your cooperation. Thank you.